What's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going to California where we're monitoring a ongoing situation. You can see right now there's already over 200,000 customers without electricity, and that number could go higher. We're going to come back and talk more about what's going on over there here in just a moment. Also in this video, I've got a brand new picture slideshow, new sky phenomena photos sent in from all around the world. But first, here at the website, checking out the Schumann resonance. Got a little bit of residue left over from the Earth-facing coronal hole. You can see we've got another one squaring off with the Earth right now as I do this video. This is an up-to-date look at the Earth-facing side of the Sun. And you can see that dark black area? That's another stream of high-speed solar wind that more than likely will be coming towards planet Earth in the next 2 to 3, maybe even 4 days. Hopping over to the USGS seismographs that are positioned around the world. For the most part, they're pretty quiet, but we've still got these seismographs up in parts of Montana and Wyoming that appear to be doing some sort of acrobatics. I'm not sure what we've got going on here, and I don't mean that literally, but the graphs show like somebody's on a trampoline bouncing up and down from time to time. They look very unusual. That one's at Fox Creek, Wyoming, which is near the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera. Flag Ranch is showing some unusual activity and has been for a while. Dillon, Montana, that one too has been showing a little bit of activity, but it's been doing that now for several weeks, so I'm not sure what's going on. If anything, it could be something as simple as a mechanical glitch. Taking a look at the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, here's the seismos around the caldera, and you can see a little bit of earthquake activity showing up on some of the eastern seismographs. Got this persistent energy across the northern now tier of the supervolcano caldera over in the northeast quadrant, the northern quadrant, and then again the northwestern quadrant, which has been busy for several months, but it seems to be moving over to the northeast. But again, everything looks pretty good, really. I mean, it's been like this for a while. As long as we don't come over here and see these things all dark blue, I'd say we're in pretty good shape. Now back to California, where you can see what's cranking off of the Pacific Northwestern coast. There's a huge, I mean a titanic low system rotating counterclockwise. It has generated a massive atmospheric river that's coming into central and parts of Northern California. It's like a giant fire hose out there off of the coast. I went to Google Earth, I looked at this area, and the area that's going to be affected the most, at least with the most rainfall, has had some wildfire activity in the past 6 months, and that means the ground is going to be very bare, if not completely absent of ground vegetation. You've got hills and canyons through here that are going to drain all of this water that's coming that way from the very strong atmospheric river. We saw this type of setup back in 2018, and it led to the massive mudslides that occurred in Montecito. I don't know if you guys remember that or not, but this was an unbelievable scene in Montecito, which is not far from Santa Barbara, California. They had an atmospheric river that dropped about 4 inches of rain over a burn scar that created a tremendous mud flow that went into Montecito carrying huge boulders like you see right there. And it was caused by a large atmospheric river that brought about 4 inches of rain very, very quickly to the area. The rain accumulation in this area, again, that has seen wildfire activity, is somewhere in the neighborhood of 7.5 inches over the next 72 hours. The majority of that coming in the next 30 hours. It's raining right now. You can look at the weather cams over here at windy.com where I'm getting these rain totals from, and I've seen other sites reporting anywhere from 6 to 10 inches of rain in this area that's full of valleys and creeks. King City is right in the middle of it, and they are looking at a total of 6.5. That's going to variate anywhere from probably 5 to 8 inches. It's going to fluctuate down here close to Cambria, 7.5 inches of rain. If you go to Cal Fire, you look at this location, you can see there were wildfires in the Morro Bay area. There was a 5,000 acre wildfire right here near El Choro Regional Park. 5,000 acres in that area, which sits right in here, which is right in the center of this heavy, heavy rainfall that is occurring right now as I do this video. You can see here at the GOES 16, come over to weathercharts.com, and I'll actually move this forward. You can see the huge atmospheric river. Look at that thing. This storm expands for over 1,500 miles, and it's a slow mover. And in fact, the low pressure system is going to move south along the west coast of the United States before it moves inland. There's also been a severe storm warning issued from Wednesday the 27th through Thursday the 28th at 9 a.m. This is going to continue all night long. Severe storm warning remains in effect until 9 a.m. on Thursday. South winds 30 to 40 knots with gusts of 50 knots. Combined seas of 14 to 18 feet are expected when conditions are worst. And that's going to be this afternoon into this evening all along this coastal area. You see here in orange and yellow. Goes on to talk about impacts. Very strong winds will create exceptionally dangerous sea conditions, which could capsize or damage vessels of all sizes. Keywords there, vessels of all sizes along this entire stretch of coastline. Right here along the west coast of California, right where that atmospheric river is making landfall. Taking a look here at Google Earth, this is where it's coming in. This area here, anywhere from, let's say, 5 to maybe 9 inches of rain. Heavy, heavy rainfall. Go up into the elevations up here into the Sierra Nevada mountains. Some areas could see 7 feet of snow, anywhere from 5 to 6. It's going to be quite common, covering a very large area. Looking here at VentureSky.com, they're showing areas of 10 inches of rain in the next, actually 12 hours. Variations from 8 to 12 to 11 to 10. And again, some of these areas have seen wildfires in the last few months. So the ground is going to be bare, setting up conditions for another round of potential mudslides. So anybody over in this area, I'm sure you're well aware of the situation. Just a big heads up, because the wind is already creating power outages of over 200,000 customers. I'm sure that number is probably going to go up, as this rain is not going anywhere for a while. This, again, atmospheric river is over 1,000 miles long, and it seems like it's growing. Going back to windy.com real quick, I want to show you guys how much snow could potentially fall up here in the Sierra Nevada mountains. I'm going to click on it real quick. 62.9 inches. That's in northern Yosemite Valley near Mammoth Lakes. 69 inches of snow. That's in the next 72 hours. Incredible snowfall, incredible rain rates. Some of these rainfall rates at times are going to be in the neighborhood of 1 inch per hour totals. Again, a massive atmospheric river coming into mainly central California, and it's extending way up into central Canada. This thing is huge. This low pressure system you see turning out here like a big cyclone, it's anchored firmly off the coast of Oregon, and it's going to move south before it moves inland. This is going to be a very long duration event that's going to bring mammoth snowfall totals to the Sierra Nevadas and unbelievable rainfall totals to central California, and it could create another round of these mudslides. So just a big heads up if you're in the central California area. I want to take you guys now down to southern Arizona, where Nick S. has shared a video with me of recent snow down in Tucson. You don't see that very often, and those are pretty good sized flakes for right out here in the desert. Thanks, Nick, for sharing. I remember that day. It was very cold outside that day. In fact, it felt very much like Flagstaff. You could even see your breath outside, which is very rare for out here in Arizona. Here's a brand new picture slideshow I put together. New sky phenomena photos sent in from all around the world. Lena M. got a unique cloud out above the Irish Sea. How do you describe that? Look at the edge on that cloud. It almost looks like a three-dimensional edge on that thing. Here it is in an inverted format. Super unique observation by Lena out above the Irish Sea. Sean out of Bakersfield, California, where we were just talking about central California. Looks like the Eye of Horus in the sky, but Bakersfield, California. Great observation. That is unedited, exactly the way I received the photograph. Crystal Lake, Illinois, Jason D. Spectacular orange and blue sunset. Waverly, Ohio, Jeff B. got a unique sky here. I don't know how to even describe that. A number 7 in the sky that's not filled with clouds over in the sunset area or the sunrise. Mary Hall from the International Space Station. More towering clouds reaching up to space visible from the space station. Tulsa, Oklahoma, Jeremy L. Or fiery orange skies. Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Jerome J. More orange and gold skies above Alabama. Shelly P. Not exactly sure what we've got going on here. Some sort of a mysterious light in the nighttime sky. Lucerne, California, Jessica Marie. Very intense. Low to the ground. Double-decker rainbow. Dan out of Calgary, Alberta. Very unique skies. Got some clouds stacked up on top of each other like lenticulars. Don't know what we got going on there. Some kind of a what looks like a three-dimensional halo. Mount Lemmon, Arizona. Photo sent in by Tony M. These are definitely lenticular clouds stacked up like pancakes above Mount Lemmon down in southern Arizona. Tanya S. out of Henderson, Nevada. Unique clouds over here. Almost looks like an eye or an eyelash in the sky. Tammy Ann out of Prescott, Arizona. Fiery orange skies, exactly the way I received the photos. Photo here sent in by Stacy R. out of Sierra Vista, Arizona. Looked outside and saw what appeared to be a big horseshoe up in the sky right out her backyard. Red Hill, South Carolina. Photo sent in by Steph of another jumbo halo. Rebecca out of Florida. Pano here of some spectacular crepuscular rays on the horizon from Florida. Great job, guys. Keep the photos coming. If you guys have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. All of the photos end up here at the Sky Phenomena Photo Gallery at the website, and sometimes I'll use them in a picture slideshow just like you saw right here. Thanks for watching. Have a super day, and be safe out there.